we talk about search and status report, how it works. Search and status report is the provides the history of the company. It is about the history of the company, what has been what has happened in the company, how it has dealt. It's a kind of the checking of the history of the company. So when we when we file the documents like any forms with the ROC and charge form with the ROC, so who can inspect those forms? Like if we do the physical inspection, anybody can do the physical inspection in the from the side of the Ministry of Corporate Affairs and can check these aspects, like whether there is any charge on the company, what who are all are the directors of the company, like the name, like corporate identification number, list of shareholders. These can be grabbed from the various documents which have been filed with the ROC. So basically the idea behind the search and status report is that not only I will not talk about the major things, but not starting from the major things, but if we talk about the banks only, if you are there, if you are if the corporate is opening a bank account, or if any housing finance company is giving a loan to the company, any financial or banking organization or is giving any loan or any charges created on the assets of the company, so they will first of all check whether there is a particular charge on their property earlier also. Not only asking from the company will help, but by doing the public inspection of those documents, they can physically as well as electronically, physically they, obviously they can go to the registrar of company and ask for the documents, because this standard has now become old. Now everything is done digitally. So if we go to the physical public inspection of those documents, they can search, they can check the charges if they are is creating on the company. So basically this idea, this chapter is all or this search and status is all about all that idea, checking the title of the company, whether the company has that title or not, of which they are talking about, of which they are taking loan upon, or any guarantee they are given, any surety they are given. So it is basically the survey of the company by checking into the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, from where when forms are filed by the company regarding their discharges, various appointments, or any major transaction that has been that has happened. So it is not only required by the banks, by the shareholders who are investing in the company, by the directors, any director who is has been invited to be appointed in the management, any independent director. So first of all they will check the history, they will have the survey of the company, they will check. So basically how it is checked, like we have first of all to log in to the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. We have to give a sign up to a login ID, sign up if you are not a registered user. If you have already a login ID in the Ministry of Corporate Affairs, you can open a login ID, you can do the physical verification. How? From by going into the MCH services, that drop down box will appear. You will check into public inspection, you can go into public inspection, you can just submit the name of the company of which you do want to do the public inspection, just pay the fees. The fees is also very nominal, that is rupees 100 per company, but per 100 for that company, you can inspect for 7 days. And how 7 days? Within 7 days, like, but if first time you have opened that company, you have done the started the verification inspection of their company, you can do that for another 3 hours. So basically the idea behind 7 days is that if it is kept as it is, not untouched, like you have not even clicked any document or have inspected any document, you can keep it for 7 days. But once you have touched any, you have inspected any document, you can inspect the document of that company for another 3 hours. So in 100 rupees you can do that public inspection of those documents. So it is done in that way, like CHG1, when a charge is created, is filed by the company, you can even inspect the CHG1 certificate if a charge is created on the company. So in a number of documents, you can check like the list of shareholders, directors by inspecting into the AOC4, NGT7. So this is the basic idea behind search and status reports. It is of much importance when you are entering into a transaction with the company, when you are giving any loan to the company by the banks, when a shareholder is investing in the company, or whether any new director is invited by the company to be appointed, or a new director is thinking about that, is thinking about going into the management of the company. So this is the idea behind search and status report. Thank you.